Morse, and I am a candidate for the Medford City Council. As a longtime Medford resident, owner-occupied landlord, disability advocate slash activist, and graduate of Medford High School, I am well-versed in issues that affect the city of Medford. I have 18 of these issues posted on my website, morseformedford.com, and my top issue is public safety. As a retired Medford Fire Department Lieutenant from Rescue 1, former EMT ambulance driver, and former CPR instructor, nothing is more important to me than life safety. I abuse the jaws of life at car accidents, and I have images in my mind that influence and affect my opinion to this day. Now, I would have supported the recent motion for funding for two new fire engines. And if I am elected to the City Council, my first motion will be to purchase another one, and here's why. Please keep in mind that the original request was for three fire engines. Now, there are six fire department stations in the city, and normally there are five engines in service. If one of these engines is out of service for any reason, the next closest engine or ladder truck will come to your home in the case of a medical emergency or a house fire. And sometimes a matter of seconds can be the difference between life and death. And we need seven mechanically sound engines to adequately cover the city, with the seventh being the backup in case of a breakdown. Now, one of the engines that is reportedly being replaced is Engine 2, which is in West Medford. It's a 13-year-old vehicle, and supposedly it's going to be going up to Engine 6, Fulton Heights, to be their new piece. Now, if my motion to purchase another engine passes, that new one should go to Engine 6 and replace their 18-year-old truck and use the former Engine 2 as the backup when a truck breaks down. Now, we also need to look at the current sound system in the stations and the deteriorating pull station systems. Also, there are too many homes in Medford without clearly visible house numbering, and dealing with that issue will be one of my top priorities on the council. Now, as a senior citizen, I understand how difficult it is to walk around Medford Square and all the other squares, and I will fight for more traffic calming measures to combat the speeding drivers. I will also fight for abatements and discounts for seniors and owner-occupied landlords on our ever-increasing and burdensome property taxes. Now, disability awareness and activism are also concerns of mine, and while there's been a lot of progress made since the ADA was passed in 92, there is still vigilance and work that needs to be done. Now, my next important issue is government civility. In 1995, I entered the political arena with a run for mayor. I was the first person to challenge the mayor, and as I look back on the campaign, it was an issue-focused debate. There were no negative ads, no personal attacks like we see too often today. Now, my main reasons for running back then were the deplorable conditions of the schools and the miles of leaking water and sewer pipes in the city. Shortly after the election, the Building the Future Committee was formed, and eventually we secured 90% state funding to help pay for all the schools. And you have to give credit to Mayor McGlynn for that. He did something that was really unique. Now, we also have a program today attempting to identify and repair the leaking water and sewer pipes. Also in 1995, I suggested that the City of Medford provide the ambulance service with a rescue ambulance like some of our surrounding communities do. Staffed by firefighters slash EMTs, not only should it generate a substantial profit for the city, it would cover the salaries of the new firefighters, and more importantly, it would provide two more personnel at every medical run in house fire. My fourth issue is small business advocacy. For many years, I've been filming videos and promoting local small businesses at no charge to them. Most recently, I filmed the grand opening of the Medford Square Diner and posted it on YouTube and many other media outlets. The majority of all job creation comes from small business owners, and we certainly should be working with and listening to them. Now, the upcoming Craddock Bridge rehabilitation is going to be a real test for every business in Medford Square and other surrounding businesses. And I have called for an official city committee to try and help deal with Medford's big dig. Please consider me for one of your votes for the Medford City Council on Tuesday, November 5th. And if you have any questions, please feel free to call me at home, 781-395-3302. I approve this message, thank you for your time, and please vote Morse, of course. And I'd like to end just by thanking Mayor McGlynn for allowing us this opportunity as candidates to get our little five-minute blurb onto the educational channel. And I'd also like to thank Allison Goldsberry and Jack Dempsey for their help.